Indicate you talk about the conversion based on the multiple unit operation. That's right, the multiple unit operation. Mostly we talk about the conversion. Conversion is the percent convert of the reactant to the product. But we talk about the reactor. But in the real process, there is more than one unit. That's right, there's more than one unit. In the real unit, we have two definition of the conversion. Like the overall conversion and the single part conversion. The single part conversion only the conversion around the reactor. That's right. If we talk about the single part conversion, we talk about the reactor. And if we talk about the overall, we talk about the overall process like this. Okay, for the reactor, we talk about what is the output reactant, what is the input reactant, how many convert reactant. And if we talk about the overall, what is the output, the overall process, what is the input, the overall process. Okay, the definition of the overall conversion, right, is the input to the process. Reactant input to the process, may not reactant output from the process. For this example, input is 75 mol A per min of the input. Reactant output, this is 75 output. That's right. Mol B, no A, that's right. A is zero. Zero, that means A is zero, no A output. And divided by the reactant input to the process, which is 75. And then you get 100% conversion. Because the output is zero. That's right, output is zero. Okay, this is the overall process. And then if you would like to determine the single part conversion, the single part conversion is the input into the reactor, minus output from the reactor. That's right, if the reactor you calculate like this, input to reactor is 100. Why is 100? Because the 100 comes from the phase speed part recycle. That's right. The feed is the phase speed part the recycle. You get 100. And the output is 75 mol A. That's right. And then you calculate a 75% conversion. That's right. This is the single part conversion. Because the conversion after reaction is only 75. If you would like to convert all of the feed, you have to recycle. When you recycle, you will increase the conversion for overall is 100. That's right. Complicate the technique, how to increase the percent conversion. But later is still the same conversion. But for this case, when you recycle, the overall is 100%. This is the important or the useful of the recycle. When you recycle the unreactant, you can forward or you can convert all of the feed, aside of the feed. Okay, this is the definition of the conversion. You have to overall and single part conversion. Like in this example. Right. For this example, we would like to produce propylene by dehydrogenation reaction. Dehydrogenation means dehydrogen from propane. From propane, produce propylene by dehydrogen. The conversion is 95%. For this case, it's the overall conversion. Overall conversion. The product stream separate into stream, product stream and recycle stream. The product stream and recycle stream. That's right. The first contain hydrogen, propylene, and 0.55% of the propane that leave the reactor. You see, leave the reactor. And propane, propylene, hydrogen. And the second stream at recycle contain the balance of unreact propane, that's right, and propylene, 5% of propylene in the first stream. That 5% of propylene in the first stream. What does it mean? This is the 5% of this. Sorry, 5% of this as recycle. This is the information, that's right. This is the information. And also the question is calculate the composition of the product. Calculate N6, N7, N8. That's right. The ratio of mole recycle to recycle, this step for this step. And single part conversion, the conversion around reactor. Okay. And then you draw the flowchart, we have three units: the mixing of recycled and fresh feed before feed to reactor, and separator to separate product and recycle. The fresh feed you feed like based on 100 mol fresh feed. What is it? 100 mol fresh feed. Only propane feed through the process. And N1 and N2 is propane and propylene from the recycle feed to the reactor. N3, N4, N5 is propane unreact, propylene and hydrogen. And the product is N6, 7, 8 is propylene, propane and hydrogen. And we know that the information is 0.555% of N3 at the N6. And you know it's 5% of 7 is N10. For this case, you can reveal the unknown. You can represent N6 in terms of N3. You can represent N10 in terms of N7. You reveal two for this case. Okay, for the next step, how to do this, you have to mix between atomic balance, species balance, that's right. For this case, okay, we have checked the overall degree of freedom. For overall, we have 1, 2, 3 unknown. That's right, 3 unknown. And only 2 atomic balance. You can balance on species or atomic balance. We have 3 unknown and 2 atomic, that's right, and 2 atomic. Okay, for this case, 2 unknown. Three unknown. Minus 2 carbon and hydrogen balance. And minus one is overall conversion is 95%. You get 0. Okay, you can do the balance for overall based on atomic balance because you know 3 unknown, 6, 7, 8. And you know 2 atomic balance, hydrogen and carbon. And you know overall conversion is 1. Okay, the first step you can make the overall balance based on atomic balance. The second one you can balance allow mixing. You check the degree of mixing. For mixing, we have 1, 2, 8, 10, 4 unknown. That's right. 4 unknown. For this case, we based on the species balance or molecular balance. Okay, for this case, we have 4 unknown and 2 balance. That's right. We have only 2, propylene and propane. There is no information. You get 2 degree of freedom. You can do. You cannot do the degree of freedom around the mixing point. You cannot do this. That's right. Okay, the third step, we check the reactor balance. Reactor balance, you can do atomic balance or molecular balance. If you balance on atomic balance, how many unknown? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 unknown. For atomic balance, 5 unknown. Minus 2 balance, that's right. To atomic CSO, we have 3 degree of freedom. We cannot solve. We go to 3. You cannot solve degree of freedom. Okay, and then you check the separator. Separator. The separator we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 unknown. That's right. And 6. And 8, you know already from 6, 7, 8, you know from the overall balance. Right. You know from the overall balance already, but now N3, 5, 4, 10, 5 unknown. For separator, you balance on the molecule balance. That's right, molecule balance. Okay. We have 5 minus 3 molecule, 1, 2, 3, minus 2 information. We know this information. We know this information. You can reduce this as that individual because to 0 degree of freedom. Okay. But now I conclude that the first step you have to make the overall balance first. This is overall. The second is the separator. Overall separator. And then you can balance on mixing. That's right. You call N9, N10, you know, only 2. And then you can balance allow reactor 1, 2, 3. Okay, what is here? For this problem, you can balance the first one overall. The second one is separator. And the third should be reactor or the mixing point. Okay. Okay, now you know the technique to solve this problem. The next, you have to convert the information that you know the 95% overall conversion. That means 5% unconvert of propane. That's right, 5% unconvert of propane. For this case, you can calculate amount of propane. That's it. That's right. Because it's the 5% of propane, 100%, 100 mole propane. That's right. Convert to the product and unconvert is 5%, 0.05 multiply 100, you get the outlet. Okay, now you know in stick already based on the conversion, because it is the overall conversion, not single part conversion. Okay, and then you check the carbon balance for overall. About the overall balance from carbon. Input only one, output one, two, you have two terms. For this case, based on steady state, input equal to output for atomic carbon. That's right. Okay, input from propane, output from propane and propylene. We have three terms, one input and two output. Input carbon, we know right, 1 mole propane input, 3 mole carbon. But we feed 100 mole propane. Okay, the output, 1 mole propane, 3 mole carbon. The output propane is N6. And 1 mole propylene, 3 mole carbon. Output propylene is N7, and you know N6 already. You can solve for N7. Okay. When you balance on carbon, you can solve for N7. And the next step, balance on hydrogen. Okay, the hydrogen. How to check the hydrogen balance first? For overall hydrogen, feed propane. Hydrogen in three also, we have four terms, one input and three output for hydrogen. Right, 100 mole propane input is mole hydrogen from 1 mole propane. Equal to N6, N6 is mole of propane output, that's right. Is mole hydrogen from 1 mole propane. And N7 is output of propane, propylene, that's right, propylene. 1 mole propylene equal to 6 mole hydrogen. This is from propane, this is from propylene, and the last one from hydrogen, that's right. 1 mole hydrogen input, 1 mole atomic hydrogen. You get for this, you know N6, N7, you can solve for N8. Now you know NS, N6, N7, that's right. N8, N6, N7, you can answer the question with the composition of the output. That's right. The output for that composition is N6, 7, 8. You know N6, N7, N8. That's right. The total is about 195, something like this. You know total, you can calculate the composition for it. 2.6%. Propane, this amount of propane output divided by total, multiply 100. This is amount of propane output divided by total, multiply 100. Okay, now you know the composition of the product stream. That's right, the product stream. And then you have to balance the recycle stream. That's right, recycle stream. To calculate from the recycle ratio, from the recycle to the first stream. Okay, from the N6, and N7, you can calculate N3 and N7. That's right. Sorry, you can calculate N3 and N10 from the information. Like this. Because you know the N3 and N6, that's right, 0.00055 N3 equal to N6, something like this. And also, you know 5% of N7, 0.005 N7 equal to N10, something like this. You can calculate N3. Okay, you can calculate N3 from this relation. Okay, and then you balance around the separation unit. That's right, separation unit. Okay, propane balance around separation unit. The propane balance, propane is N3 equal to N6 plus N9. That's right. entry inlet equal to outlet N6 plus N9. You know N6, you know N3, you can calculate N9. You can calculate N9. Okay, you can calculate N9. Now you know recycle stream, you know product stream. But for this case, you can balance allow separator to calculate N4 and N5, and you can balance allow mixing to calculate N1 and N2. Okay, but you're not necessary to know this because there is no question about it, but you can do that. You can do that. Okay, for this problem, we only do the overall hydrogen, the propane balance allow the mixing point. That's that. Mixing point. Okay, for the mixing point of propane balance, propane balance is 100 equal to N1 plus N9. 100 equal to N1 plus N9. You know N9, you can calculate N1. That's that. You can calculate N1. And also you make the propylene balance. This is C3S8 balance. C3S6 balance. For this case, it's 0 equal to N2 plus N10. That's right. N2 plus N10. And then you can solve for N2. Okay. Now you know N1. You know N1. And right, for this case, we would like to calculate the recycle ratio. This time, recycle ratio. The recycle ratio is N9 plus N10 divided by 100. That's right. Recycle to festive. This question. Okay, now you know the recycle to festive ratio for this case. And then you calculate the single part conversion. You know N1. That's right. You know N1. And you know N3 already. N3. N1 minus N3 divided by N1. Multiply by 100, you get the single part conversion. That's right. Single part conversion. 9.6%. This 9.6%. You can see that the single part is only 9.6 because do we have the recycle? The overall conversion is 95 for this problem. It's 95%. Only 5% are converted, but only is 9.6% for reactor. But overall is 95 because this is the importance of recycle. And also, if we would like to know N4 and N5. Or N2, you can balance allow reactor, or you can balance allow separator, or firstly, you can solve for it. But for this problem, only for this, because you would like to know the ratio of recycle to firstly and the single part conversion like this. Okay, this is the technique to solve for multiple unit and also the recycle, include the chemical reaction. Okay, the next example that we talk about the bypass or purse, something like this. The pursing is used to prevent the accumulation, that's right. To prevent the accumulation due to the recycle stream and there is in. Okay. For this case, what does it mean? Some fraction of the recycle stream is purged out of the system. That's right. For this case, we have the product stream and we have the recycle stream. But for this case, we have some split through the purse stream, to the purse stream. Okay. This is the pursing is to prevent the accumulation, to prevent the accumulation in the system based on high value of the recycle, as I have of the recycle. Okay, this is an example. You talk about the bypass or purse stream. As I also, sorry, the bypass means sometimes we have split of the input. This bypass, that's right, this bypass. And the purse is we split out of the recycle stream. The bypass means split for the feed stream to mix with the product. For this case, we would like to adapt the product composition to dilute the product, something like this. Okay, we talked this already for bypass. Okay, now we talk about the purse stream. Okay, for this case, we would like to produce methanol. by the chemical reaction of carbon dioxide with hydrogen. Carbon dioxide with hydrogen. We produce the methanol and water. And then the first step, we have to check the balance already or not. One carbon. Two oxygen. Six hydrogen, three, four, five, six. Okay, the atom balance already. That's right. The first feed to the process contain hydrogen, carbon dioxide, and inert. That's right. We have three components, hydrogen, carbon dioxide, and inert. Inert is 0.4%. And the reactor effluent, the exit of the reactor is sent to the condenser. That's right. Sent to the condenser to remove all of methanol and water. And non oxygen or in. And then some part of the separator is recycled. That's right. It's recycled to the reactor. And then to prevent the avoiding or build up the inert in the system, we purchase it to withdraw the recycle. That's right. Okay, the feed to reactor contain 28% CO2, 70% hydrogen, and 2% inert. This is the feed to reactor, not feed to the overall process. And the single part conversion is 60% for hydrogen. This is the conversion around reactor. Okay, the question is calculate the molar flow rate and molar composition of fresh feed. Because we know only 0.4% inert. How many carbon dioxide, how many hydrogen feed to the system? And total feed to the reactor. Total feed to reactor is include fresh feed part recycle, right? And feed stream, recycle stream, and first stream. Okay, for this case, we calculate based on the production rate of methanol is 155 kilomole methanol per hour. This is the target of our production. We would like to produce 155 kilomole of methanol per hour. Okay, for this case, we know amount only the product stream, but this number is not convenient to calculate. It's not convenient. Sometimes you can calculate based on 100 mole or 1 mole of production, and then you can scale up. That's right, scaling up. Okay, we have to take it. You calculate based on this real number, or you can calculate based on the assumption of 100 mole methanol product per hour or 1 mole. That's right. It's up to you. But for this example, we calculate based on 100 mole. After you solve for all unknown, and then you can scale up to the 155. Yeah. Okay, for this case, we make the diagram based on 100 mole of the combined fresh feed. That's right, 100 mole of combined fresh feed or 100 mole of the product. That's right. Okay, we calculate based on 100 mole of the combined fresh feed. Okay. And then you can scale up to the 155, okay. Okay, from the problem statement, you don't know N0 feed to the process, you don't know. You don't know about of CO2, that's right. You don't know the composition of CO2. You know the composition of inert, it's 0.4% or 0.004 mole inert per mole, that's right. And XOC mean composition of CO2. And how about conversion of the H2O is 1 minus 0.004. That's right. Minus XOC equal to the composition of hydrogen. Okay. This is the input to the process is two unknown, NO and XCO. The feed to the reactor, you know the composition. We assume 100 mole. For this, and output the reactor N1, N2, N3, N4, N1 is CO2, N2 is hydrogen. You know amount of the mole of inert is 2 mole. Based on this, 100 multiplied 0.02 because inert equal to outlet. That's right. Okay, N3 is methanol, N4 is water. Our condenser or separator. The product only methanol and water with the viscosity. And the recycle and first include CO2, hydrogen, and inert, no methanol. That's right, no methanol and water. Right. for the recycle only carbon dioxide, hydrogen, and ammonia. The first recycle and this steam is the same composition. The same composition, that what does it mean? X5C composition of CO2 in recycle, the same composition in the first, and the same the output of this. Hydrogen, composition of hydrogen, the same. And also the composition of inert, one minus composition of CO2 minus composition of hydrogen, is the same. Okay, from this stream, this three stream, the same composition. That's right, the same composition, but different in the amount. That's right. NR, NP, N5 is different, but the same composition. Okay, this is the flow chart to calculate the balance around this system. Okay, you can check the first degree of freedom. We have many, many techniques, many, many degrees. We have allow mixing, allow reactor, allow condenser, allow mixing, 1, 2, 3, 4, and overall, right, you can check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 degree of freedom, if possible. Okay, if we check the overall first, overall we have 7 unknown, that's right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's right. This is the overall. We have 1, 2, 2 inlet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's right. 5 outlet. Totally 7 unknown. Right. 7 unknown. For this case, if we would like to balance on the species balance or molecule balance, okay, 7 unknown. We have one reaction plus one. And we have 7 or 5 different balance. That's right. CO2 hydrogen in the methanol of water. We have 3 degrees of freedom. For this case, you cannot balance on overall. You cannot do the balance for overall. Okay, the next step, we check the recycle feed, the mixing. Like this. We have 1, 2. We have recycle also. That's right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 unknown, 5 unknown, and 3 balance. We get 2 degrees of freedom. You cannot solve. Okay, you cannot solve. Then the next step, we balance around reactor. For reactor, you can balance on molecular balance, atomic balance. Can do for both, and it can operate and also. But for this case, if we balance on the atomic balance, we have unknown is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 unknown. And we have 3. That's right. 4 unknown plus 1 reaction minus 3 atom minus 1 inert. And I'm not sure we have one, and we have one information. That's right. Okay. We have 4 unknown, 1 reaction, 4 balance. Okay, 4 balance. For this case, we balance we have balance on the molecule balance, also atomic balance. You can do for this. Okay, for this, we will show you the molecule balance. That's right. 4 unknown, 1 reaction, 4 balance reaction, and 1 single part conversion. We have 0 degree of freedom. That's right. We have 0 degree of freedom. If we do about the atomic balance, if we have about atomic balance, we have 4 unknown, 1 reaction. Atomic balance, sorry. For atomic balance, that's like unknown and unknowns and chemical reaction, that's right. And independent non-reactive species, okay. For unknown, that's right, minus 1, 2, 3. 3 and 1 inert. Okay, we get 0 degree of freedom also for atomic balance. You can solve for atomic balance. you can solve for mole foot balance for this case. Okay, for this we can solve the reactor first. That's right. The reactor first because the degree of freedom is zero, and then you check the condenser. You check the condenser. We have three unknown also. Condenser. We have 1, 2, 3. That's right. Three unknown because N4 and N3 you know already from the reactor balance. That's right. Three unknown. You can balance three species. Okay. Three unknown and three balance. You can solve for condenser. Now you check the first physical state. Two unknown and one independent equation. Okay. The first one. The second one. You cannot solve this because this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 unknown. That's right. 5 unknown. If you solve a Laplace condenser, you know in 5, if you know this is 1, 2. Now you have 2 unknown. Okay, again, the first one, the second one. From this case, you know this, you know X5C, X5S. You know this already, you know this already. Okay, for the pristine and recycle, we have 2 unknown. But only one independent equation we have. Because why we have only one? Because this is the same composition. CO2 the same composition, hydrogen the same composition, inert the same composition. For these three, not only one independent equation, we cannot solve this, okay. The first, the second, that's right. The third one, you have to balance on the phase speed. That's right. The first physical state you cannot do. You have to balance the phase speed of the mixing. Okay, you can balance around this, the third one. That's right. The third one, you can balance around this. Okay, we don't do 1, 2, 3 unknown. That's right. This is not already, not already. We have 3 unknown, and we have CO, hydrogen, and inert balance. You can solve for this. Okay, and the last one. Like this. This is the step to do the mass balance. For this case, you can balance on that's like the molecule balance is the only single reaction. And also you can balance on atomic or actin operation. Okay. Look at it in the detail. Okay, the first step, you have to analyze it of the information. For this case, you know the single part conversion, 60%. That's right. The 60%, that means 40% unconvert of hydrogen. That's a hydrogen feed to the reactor is 70, 0.7 multiplied 100, you get 70 multiplied 0.4. You know about of hydrogen output is N2, you know N2 already from the single part conversion. That's right. This is the single part conversion. Please remember that the single part only the conversion around the reactor. Okay, you know N2. Okay, the next one, you balance on reactor. That's right. Okay, hydrogen balance. Hydrogen balance. Input minus output. Hydrogen is reactant minus consumption. That's right. Equal to accumulation. Finally, you get consumption equal to input minus output. Okay, hydrogen consumption equal to input. You know input 70. You know output 28 is output. You know consumption of hydrogen 42. We did the hydrogen consume. That's right. Okay, the next one you balance on CO2 balance. Also, CO2 is the reactant, no generation. And this is the output equal to input minus consumption. That's right. Output of carbon dioxide is N1. You know input is 28. This is input to the reactor. Now we make the balance around reactor. You know input of the carbon dioxide, hydrogen, and inert already. Okay. Okay. Input CO2 minus consumption. For this case, we calculate based on hydrogen consumed. That's a hydrogen consumed. For this case, 3 mole hydrogen. We need 1 mole CO2. 3 mole hydrogen consumed need 1 mole CO2 consumed. That's right. The free hydrogen is 42. Right? And then you can calculate N1. Okay, the next one is methanol balance. input minus output plus generation equal to zero. But for this case, there is no methanol input. Finally, you get output equal to generation. That's right. Okay, the methanol output is entry. Entry equal to generation. For this case, we calculate based on hydrogen consumed. 3 mole hydrogen consumed generate 1 mole methanol. 1 mole methanol. Okay. The hydrogen consumed is 42. That's right. You calculate 14 mole of methanol produced. The last one, water balance. And also, water balance is output equal to generation. There is no input. For output of water. That's right. 3 mole hydrogen consume, 1 mole water generate. And you know it's 42 mole of hydrogen consume. You can calculate N4. Okay, from this case, you can calculate the output carbon dioxide is 14 mole CO2. Output methanol, output water is the same, 14 mole. That's right. Okay. And then next, balance on condenser. That's right. Balance on condenser. If you take the total mass balance on condenser, total mass balance on condenser. That's right. Is N1 plus N2 plus 2 plus N3 plus N4 equal to N5 plus N3 plus N4. Is it the total mass balance? That's right. N1 plus N2 plus N3 plus N4 plus 2. This is the input to the condenser. The output we have two steam, product steam. N3 plus N4 and the recycle steam and first N5. Previously, you know N2, N1, N3, N4. You can calculate N5. I see. You can calculate N5. Okay, the next step, you can balance on carbon dioxide balance. This is only the condenser, no reaction. That's right, no generation, no consumption. Input equal to output. CO2 balance, N1. Equal to X5C multiply N5. That's right. There is no CO2 in this thing. Okay. N1 equal to N5, X5C. You know N1, you know N5, you calculate X5C. And then you balance on hydrogen balance. Hydrogen is N2 equal to N5, X5S. That's right. No hydrogen here. Okay. N2 equal to N5, X5S. You know N2, you know X5, you can calculate X5S. You can calculate X5S. And also you can calculate XI is inner conversion. That's right. From 1 minute X5, 3 minute X5S. Like this. Okay, this is you balance allow reactor, you balance allow condenser, and then balance allow phase. Fit to recycle mixing. Balance now this. Total mass is N0 equal to 100 plus NR, right? 100 plus NR. This is the first one. N0, NR is unknown. And then you can balance on inverse balance. Inverse balance is NO 0.004 equal to NR by 1 minus X5C minus X5S plus 0.02 100. So you know X5, you know this already. That's right. And then you have two unknown. Two equations you can solve for this. Like this. Okay, you can solve for N0 and you can solve for NR. Okay, and then you make the carbon dioxide balance. Input equal to output also. CO2 balance. NOXOC equal to NRX5C plus 0.2S100. That's right. You can solve the negative. Like this. You can solve for XOC because you know N0, you know NR, you know X5C. And then you can calculate XOS, that's right, from this. Okay, and then you make the total moon balance around this. That's right. You balance around this already. You balance this already. This already. And then you balance the last one. Total balance is NR plus NP equal to N5. You know NR, you know N5. You can solve for NP like this. Okay, you know NP already. Okay. For this case, we calculate based on 100 mole feed to the reactor. 100 mole feed to the reactor. For 100 mole feed to the reactor, you produce the product entry is 14. That's right. 14 mole of methanol. But for this case, we would like to produce 155 kilomole of methanol. For the case, we have to scale up from 14 to 155, like this. Okay. All right. The 14 mole, that's right. This 155, you have to scale up by 11.1. That's right. You have to multiply all amount that's produced, that generate, that consume in the flow chart by this factor. But the composition is still the same. Do not change the composition, but only amount have to change. For example, fresh feed, this is based on 100 mole. That's right. 100 mole fresh feed of 14 is N3. That's right. 14 N3 for this case. But the real system, we would like to produce N3 equal to 1.5. This is 14. We have to scale up from 14 to 1.5. By multiply by 11.1. Multiply this term by this, by this, by this, by this. You get amount. But the composition is the same. That's right. The composition is the same. Okay, for the scale up and the lower scale. Okay, did it give you some example of the application of the material balance that's included in chemical reaction? Right. In the system. We can balance on atomic balance, molecules balance, or action of reaction. That's why if the multiple system, you can make overall on the atomic balance. But if you balance around the system with no reaction, the molecule balance is bigger. But for the system with input reaction, you can do for the atomic balance, molecule balance, and the action of reaction. That's right. We have three techniques for the system with involve the chemical reaction. Okay, for this case, it gives you the true example for the chemical reaction based on single unit and multiple unit. And also for the multiple unit, we have like recycle, we have the bypass, we have the person, that's not the person. And also if you consider like this system, you have to consider the two technique of the conversion. We have overall conversion and single part conversion. The single part conversion, we talk about the conversion for only for the reactor. That's right. The reactor. If you would like to increase the conversion in the process, you can do the add some recycle. We consider the overall conversion based on feed to the process and outlet on the process. Okay. But today, I would like